Hey my YouTube friends, welcome back.
Today we have a AC disconnect we need to add for this particular job. We had to relocate the AC breaker to the inside panel. Let's take a look. This is the AC breaker, used to be here. It got relocated inside so it would be on a backup of a battery and solar install. That would be considered the disconnect if it's close. But now the AC is over here, and if I'm a worker and I want to work on that AC, there's no way for me to shut this AC off without going in the garage, which is out of sight. And the inspector probably won't like that, so we need to add a disconnect right there. We have a 60 amp AC disconnect just for this purpose. So let's go ahead and prepare this disconnect. We can take this piece out. We don't need it for now, it's gonna be in the way. We can work with this cover on, but there's an easy way to remove it. You take a screwdriver and you can pry this open a little bit or just lift it off and it should come out. Oh, this one won't. Okay, you just stick the screwdriver right in between here, give it a little twist, that'll give it enough room to take the cover off. Makes it much less of a pain. So we need to tap onto this, the wall. We need to get here, here. This is in the way, but this will open. Same thing, pop a screwdriver in. We're going to use half inch Carflex that's already there. We'll take it out and put it in the bottom, but we need to remove these half inch KO seals. So I don't want to keep the customer with the AC down for too long, so I'm going to prepare this as much as possible. Get the connectors in, get a measurement on the flex, and we'll do that next. If you look inside the existing, we have two 10 wires coming in and one 12 ground. So what I did is, I'm gonna take this off, pull it back, and connect it to my line in. So that's gonna make this too short. So I went ahead and pre-cut a new piece that will fit all the way over. I measured it all the way over. Sorry for the camera work, guys. All the way over to here. And I'm gonna fill it with 2 10s and a 12 ground. So I know I said I'd use 2 10s for my huts and a 12 ground, but I don't have any 12 ground. I do have 10, which is the next size bigger. So it doesn't matter if you go bigger, as long as wire size is not an issue, as long as conduit fill is not an issue. And in this case, conduit fill is not an issue at all, so we can always go bigger on the wires. And in this case, it's going to be a bigger ground, just because I don't have any 12, but I do have 10. So this is the size of the pre-cut conduit. Just going to go ahead and feed some wire in here. Like I said, I don't want the homeowner to go too long without AC, so I'm going to do as much as I can now before I disconnect his AC. I'm gonna feed this with how much wire I need. sometimes it's kind of hard to feed it in. Just going around a corner. You step on it and hold it straight, you feed this straight down, it'll go right in. It'll come out the other side like it is. Pull extra, so you have it. And this side works out perfect for the ground. Gone. And we'll cut some extra on the other side. Boom. We have our flex pre-made, ready to go. Okay, as you see, I started already wiring the load side. Alright, I still haven't shut the customer's power off. I already put my little replacement flex over here with wires in it, and that will reach up to the AC. I already took the strap, put a new strap. I'll take this strap right over here, pull that up. How do I know which one's line and load? It doesn't even have it marked. This inside cover I took off, it says on it, right here, it's very hard to distinguish. All right, the outside ones are load, the inside are line. Load is always your appliance. The line is always coming from your electrical panel. That's how we know. All right, we're ready to change over. I've gone as far as I can without interrupting power. Important. We want to make sure the AC is off. Okay, this one here. Don't want to work on it hot. Always make sure the power is off. Never assume and just go for it. Always make sure it's off. Touch on the contactors here. And 2 volts, yeah, I'm not too worried. It's off. Okay guys, that literally took me less than 5 minutes. This piece is all strapped in and connected now. I'll connect it back up. Ground is grounded. Just gonna put a strap on here. It's all wired in. These sides of my line coming from the panel, electrical. And these two are my load. I'm gonna go ahead and turn it on, check the voltage, and then plug that disconnect back in. Okay, power's back on. I need to check my meter. That should be tricky. That's a cool angle. Alright, this should be my line. These two, if I can hold them together. Okay. 246 down the bottom. Nothing. That's my line size, so I got good power there. Almost all back together. And if you notice right here, it says on and off upside down. If you have this pushed in and the on is up, that means there's power now going to the unit or whatever you're disconnecting. If the off is up, it's not passing power. The unit is off. And that's all there is to that. There's your disconnect. Person can come work on the AC, pull that handle out. See you on the next one, guys.